Hello and welcome. Today we will discuss the plant layout of WT, that is first unit and the second topic of the first unit in WT. Today we will discuss about plant layout. So as we have already studied about the first portion of the first topic of the first unit. For today we will discuss second topic and second portion of the first unit, that is plant layout. So what is plant layout? Yes, please. So today we'll be discussing plant layout. What is plant layout? What are the objectives of a plant? What are the objectives of a good plant? And how these efficient and high productivity plant works? And more than that, application of these all these plants, and what are the types of plants? Okay, so what is the meaning of plant layout? A plant layout, as we know, that a plant is a facility where we manufacture products or parts. So plant is a facility where do we manufacture parts or products. So layout, as all of us know, is the basic lay or a basic design on which a whole manufacturing facility is designed. For example, we have a home. So first of all, once we buy the land, we design a layout. That means where from we have to enter the home, and where from we have to keep our drawing rooms and bedrooms and kitchens and stores and everything. So similarly, in a plant layout, we basically put the basic design where from the material will come in and where it will leave the plant, and how it will sail through different processes, and how the work will be done on the product. So this is complete system, complete objective, complete overview of how the product is enters and how it leaves is known as plant layout. So a plant layout refers to the arrangement of machinery and other industrial facilities such as receiving and shipping departments. That means the product comes in, the raw material comes in, it is processed stage wise, and then the raw material leaves the plant. At the same time, the objective of the plant layout is also to facilitate not only material but also to employees. So where do the workers will come and where will they leave? So this is also to facilitate not only material but also to other to the employees also, and also other amenities like the other material is coming apart from raw material. So all these should be well handled and should be well versed. That is the meaning or objective of the good plant layout. So plant layout means the basic arrangement and how the material enters, raw material enters, and how it is processed, then how does it leave. Okay. So plant layout study is compulsory because not only when a new plant or new manufacturing facility is being erected, it is also useful for studying the existing plants, so that what are the hindrances and how the productivity is affected by the current layout, and how the hindrances or objections or obstacles can be removed. So the study of the plant layout is not only to erect a new plant or new manufacturing facility, but also to facilitate the existing manufacturing facility. So what are the objectives of good plant what are the objectives of good plant layout? Objectives are, we have to provide enough production capacity. That means number of machines or number of processes installed must be fully capable of delivering with all out efficiency. So for example, if we do have machines, if we do have processes, they should be fully utilized, and that is the objective of a good plant layout. So that there is minimum material travel, minimum hindrances that occur. So objective of good plant layout is that it should be fully utilizing all the machineries it has. Then material, reducing material handling cost. That means the material, the raw material should, the travel of the raw material should be minimized. It should not go there and there and hectic module. It should be streamlined, and minimum distance it should cover when it enters the plant and it leaves the plant. Also, to reduce hazards to personnel, that means the basic motive or basic objective of the plant layout is that the workers, employees who are working there should also not be exposed to the hazards of manufacturing facility. Also, to reduce hazards or the hindrances or the negative parts of the manufacturing. Also, to increase employee morale. That means they should be energetic enough, they should be given, they should be provided such a facility in the plant layout so that they have to move minimal, and they should be that would increase their boost, and that would increase their working capacity and working morale. So increase employee morale. Reduce accident. Another important part is, and another important part is that good plant layout must not occur any accidents of any type, whether machine to man or machine to machine. So it should reduce all types of accidents, and it should not, the accident should not occur. Then come to utilize available space. That is the objective of a good plant layout, that all the space should be fully utilized to its capacity, and no space should be left unused. So that is also the objective of a good plant layout. Then provide ease of production. That means manufacturing should be made easy, and the flow of the material and men should be such that the manufacturing is made easy and manufacturing is made smooth. At the same time, it should also provide easiness to the maintenance. So not only should be production is easiness, but also maintenance easiness, because maintenance is a part of production. Every fixed interval, the maintenance takes place of the machines. So maintenance should also be easy in order to have a good plant layout. At the same time, supervision must also be easy. And last but not least is the productivity. Productivity, we are all concerned with the productivity. All engineering is concerned with the productivity, because if productivity is not there, we are going to lose a lot of money. So productivity, good objective, the good plant layout, objective of the good plant layout is that it must have good productivity, must have increased productivity, and it should not affect the productivity. So when smoothness of production is there, so utilization of manufacturing facility is there, productivity will automatically gets higher and higher. So allow high machine utilization is also related with the productivity. As I told, that productivity is a combination of man to machine working. So once we talk about improved productivity, that also consists of higher machine utilization or full machine utilization. That is the objective of the good plant layout. So these are the objectives of good plant layout. What are the requirements and how they can be achieved? Next is factors influencing plant layout. Factors influencing plant layout. What are the factors that basically affect the plant layout? Number one is plant layout. Basically, if we analyze a few plants, we'll find that the manufacturing is not easy. Manufacturing is not made easy. So material goes here and there, spectacle, and also the workers working there don't find streamline in their movement. So these are the factors that we have to take. So first of all, we need to streamline the material, right? Because material is made to enter in the facility and there it is processed, and after processing it is sent outside. So we must, first of all, we must enforce to streamlining of the material. So this is the factor influencing plant layout. So the factor is that the material transfer should be streamlined. So it is the most important factor that basically takes place. So then second is geographical limitation of the site. That means the manufacturing facility is surrounded by other plants and other facilities, because mostly there are production facility, there is an economic zone or production zone. So most of the time they have all manufacturing facility together. So global limitation is also, that means which site we have to give, which site the plant is accessible and which site plant is not accessible. Roads, etc., are the factors that affect the plant layout. So this is second. First is transfer of material. Second is geographical location, which site the road is there of the plant, and depending upon this road or approach to the manufacturing facility, the plant layout will be made. And third is interaction with existing or plant facilities on site, such as existing roadways, drainage and utilities routings. So this is the apart from roadside, apart from the approach, also the drainage and utilities routings, drainage and also the water supply. These are also the prime concern of designing a manufacturing plant. The need for plant operability and maintainability, and this is also associated with the geographical limitation, because we know road or approach is very important as far as movement of material and movement of men is concerned. So which side the material is entering the plant and which side the persons or worker or employees working there approach to the plant is of the main concern. Next is the need to prevent confinement where release of flammable substances may occur. Apart from raw material, there are other supplies also, like petroleum products, like kerosene, like other coolants and other flammable materials, gases, etc., are utilized in manufacturing facility. So where these flammable materials and hazardous materials are stored in the plant is also of utmost important, because if it is near to the manufacturing facility, it is very much inside the heart of the manufacturing facility, and if any accident occur, that will affect the whole plant. So that the electrical transformers and these facilities who are more these facilities and they are more these storages who are more spectacle to the fire and accidents are designed at a safe way in order not to have accidents in the plant. And last is emergency escape. So that that is also a factor that basically affect the plant layout. So in case of emergency, how people will leave, how workers will leave, that is the main concern of the factor that is influencing the plant layout. Then principles of plant layout. We already talked about the objectives. When we have the objectives, we must be driving the principles of how to draw a good plant layout. So the principle of minimum travel, as we discussed earlier, that the material as well as men or operators or workers or employees must travel minimum. Their travel should be less covering inside the plant. Also, the accessories like kerosene, like petrols, like other gases, like other maintenance parts, all these should travel minimal in the plant. So the principle of minimum travel. Then principle of sequencing, that is also very much important, because if sequences is not followed, so process 2 is not followed by process 1, then it will create hazard. If process 2 is here, process 5 is here, process 1 is here, process 5, so this will create a haphazard movement of the material. So the principle of sequencing, that is the product must sail smooth inside a plant as well as person. Then principle of usage, that is completely using the infrastructure that we do have in the manufacturing facilities. That is principle of usage. Fourth is principle of compactness, that is two operations must be compatible each other, that are placed together. For example, we have fire in one department and we have flammables in another department or another shop. We cannot place these two shops together, because there are chances that if any fire leaks or any hazardous material leak, it will catch fire. So there are chances of accidents. So these we have to take care. This is also concerned with the safety. So inside the plant, we have to take care of all the safety norms for accidents. Safety norms from the accidents. So we have to take care of the persons who are working there. Any type of accident should be avoided and should be carefully designed the plant layout so that there is no accident. So maximum safety concern is with the plant layout. Principle of satisfaction. Satisfaction means the worker who are working there should feel positive, so that they give maximum productivity and they give higher productivity in order to have full capacity working of the plant. So satisfaction is an important thing. So and last is principle of minimum investment. Principle of minimum investment is that the plant should be designed in such a way that it consumes minimum amount of money. So minimum investment, no extra money should be invested, no additional money should be invested in order to make a good plant. So these are the principles of plant layout. Next is types of plant layout. What types of plants layout are there? So we have talked objectives, then we have talked factors that affect plant layout, then we have talked principles. Now it is a type of layout. So we have five types of plants layout. One is process layout, product layout, exposition layout, cellular layout, and a combination of hybrid. So first we'll discuss about the process layout. Process layout is also called job layout and functional layout. Job layout and functional layout. Whereas product layout or line processing layout, product layout is also called line processing, and process layout or job layout or functional layout. This is like this. Process layout, that is all the processes or machines are placed together. For example, we have a lathe segment at one place, then milling segment at another place, drilling segment another place, grinding segment at another place and painting facility at another place. So this is the process layout. We have lathe department or lathe shop. All lathes are kept together and any type of lathe work will be done in this lathe department only. In milling department, all types of milling work will be done in this department only. Similarly, drilling deals another specific department or a specialized department will be dealing with the drilling. Paint, like paint and grinding and assembly. So all these are different shops that are clubbed together. So different shops clubbed together. So process layout are the process layout. Like this. So process layout are the layout in which what types of processes are kept together, another type of processes kept another. Then comes to the product layout. Second type is product layout. Product layout or line layout is a product enters, all the machines are streamlined so that the product moves in and moves out in a streamlined, in a straight line motion. I will give the example, like I have a product that is basically, that is coming raw material, and this raw material is first drilled and then this product is machined, this product is milled, and then this product is painted. So first this product, the product will enter and we have a drilling machine. Then we don't have process type layout so that the product goes to process. Once it is, the drilling is done, then it goes to the another process, that the drill is, the milling is done, and then this is, it goes to paint shop. Rather than the machines are clubbed together in order to facilitate the product. So it is customized layout, and first of all the product is, the drilling is done on the product. So drilling machine is there, then milling machine is there that basically performs some milling operation or cuts a slot. Then there is paint shop, and then paint shop, there is a paint facility and the product is painted and then it goes out. So this is called a product layout or line layout. In this line layout, the product goes inside, performs all the products, and then it goes outside the plant. Third is fixed position layout. Sometimes we do have parts or product that are so huge or so bulky that we cannot move together. For example, we are manufacturing a ship. It is not possible to take the ship to the manufacturing, to the lathe machine, then to the milling machine, then to the paint shop. What we do, we put a structure on the site itself. We have to make a ship. So on the shore, we make a ship, and all the processes are done together. Similarly, if all the product is there, all the services rotate around the product. For example, aircraft assembly. So we have to put an aircraft at the place there. We have to put the structure, we have to put the basic structure of the aircraft at one place. All the parts and components will be assembled on that only, and all the processes will take place on that only, and then ultimately the product will be completed at the site itself rather than moving here and there. Fourth one is cellular layout. Cellular layout means we have different cells for particular products. We have type of A raw material, C raw material, B raw material. So these are three different types of raw materials, and these come and go into a particular cell. Particular cell performs all the operations as compared, performs all the operations, and then this process goes to assembly. So we have a streamlining of the products, and there we do have different parts or different components, and there they go through cell 1, cell 2 and cell 3, and all these are clubbed together at assembly area, and there they are assembled and sent out. Last one is combination layout. Cellular layout, last one is combination layout. Combination layout is basically a hybrid of product layout and process layout. In product layout, what we do, we put the product, we put all the processes in line for the product, for a particular product. Whereas in process, what we do, we keep all the processes together. So in the slide, this is the process layout, where all the processes are kept together, all the similar machines are kept together. Milling machine is there, lathe machine is there, and lathe shop is there. All the lathe are kept in the lathe shop, whereas all the milling machines are kept in the milling shop. And in product, the machines are placed together to facilitate the production, to facilitate a particular product. In combination of these two layouts, the product as well as shops are placed together. We have a particular shop, we have different types of particular shops, and different types of products are coming, and they pass through the different shops, and they keep on working until they are processed, the work is done on them, and once they are complete, they send to the delivery of outside the product. So this is a combination layout. Combination means both the good features of process and product layout are combined together in order to facilitate the product as well as market. So this was about the product layout, and this is complete unit. Now I think everything is clear about objectives. I discussed about meaning, definition and scope, then objectives of good plant layout, then factors, and then types, principles and types. So this is all about the manufacturing plant layout. Okay, thank you.